Reflection, Chapter 23. Mulan writhed, wrestling Hugui's claws for a way out of his grip. His fingers were thick and bulbous as a tiger's, and his talons alone were bigger than her hands. He was all scales and smoke. Touching his skin scalded her. Breathing pinched her lungs. She desperately reached for the sword at her hip. No use. Even if she could get to it, Hugui had wrapped his fingers so tight around her waist, he could easily have snapped her in half. They swooped up. The volcano's rocky face rushed in front of her, followed by a wave of heat. When the smoke cleared, she could see the volcano's expanse from their height in the sky. Here, the river no longer hung in the sky. It gushed over the mountain, blanketing its shiny orange and red seams of lava. As her feet dangled preparatively over its waters, she spotted the black pillar on the other side of the river. Hugui had flown them to the peak. She squirmed again, trying to twist her way out so she could see her friends. "Let me go!" she shouted. "Let me..." Her shouts became a gasp when the fire demon suddenly dropped her. It wasn't a fatally high drop, but it was painful. Mulan landed on a harsh bed of rock and bones. Her sword clattered next to her on the volcano's wide rim. She lifted her head first, and then her hands and legs. Nothing was broken, but she winced as she moved her ankle. The fall hadn't helped it. If not for her armor, she might have hit one of the rocks and suffered worse. She looked up. The sky was bloodshot, and she saw Hugui disappear into the clouds, his wings beating a powerful torrent of embers and ash swept up from the volcano. The ground steamed in pale gold ribbons and the rock shiny with heat. Around her were charred bones, cracked demon skulls, and battered shields and spearheads. Smoke hissed from the rocks, and molten stone bubbled within the cracks in the ground. Craters as wide as ponds dimpled the surface, boiling with the earth's red-hot soup. Columns of black rock veined with glowing red lava protruded from the summit. The Chamber of Boiling Despair, she remembered with a shudder. This is what May tried to warn us about. This volcano must be the cauldron. From below, she thought that the volcano's peak was flat. Now that she was at top, she realized she'd been wrong. The ground sloped inward like a bowl, like the cauldron it had been named for, and she landed on its rim. Mulan pulled herself up and watched in reached for her sword. Bruises splotched her body, but she ignored the pain and ran to the edge of the rim to search for Shang and Shishi. No sign of them, or Hugui. Smoke curled everywhere, obscuring her vision. She clenched her fist. The last time she'd seen Shang and Shishi, the demon's fire had ruptured the ground. Maybe they had fallen deeper into Dayu. Maybe they were dead. They're still alive, Mulan told herself. They have to be. But even if Shang and Shishi were alive, could she find them up from this peak? Why had Hugui dropped her off here? Probably so he could come back for me later, she thought with a shiver. Fear wretched Mulan's gut. She could be defeated. How could she defeat a demon powerful enough to split the earth and strong enough to toss them about as if they were mere checker pieces? She coughed, holding her sleeve up to her mouth to keep the ash out of her lungs. She needed to get to the pillar. Reaching it had been their goal before they'd gotten separated, and if there was a hope of reuniting with her friends, it'll be there. As some of the smoke cleared, Mulan took a good, hard look at the pillar. As she feared, the pillar was on the opposite side of the river of hopelessness. Its swirling water surged across the center of the cauldron, then plunged off the edge of its black, looming waterfall. Shrill screams resonated from its depths. Maybe there's a way around it, she thought with a gulp. The smoke thickened. Mulan coughed and trod outward, fanning the air with her hands. She spotted an old shield left behind and picked it up. Scorch marks blackened the iron surface, but at least it would protect her as she searched for her friends. Fire lit the way. Hugui, Mulan said, recognizing the swirls of smoke and fire. They were coming from below. She ran to the brink of the cauldron to get a better look. Her heart jumped when she spotted Shang and Shishi on a ledge halfway up the cauldron. They hadn't fallen after all. Shang, she shouted. I'm here. Shang, who just picked up a spear, heard her. Mulan, where? From out of the shadow, Hugui drawed himself up. Against the mountain, Mulan took account of his staggering size. His feet were planted on the ledge, but the tips of his wings nearly reached the top of the cauldron. Mulan ducked before he grabbed her again. Hugui raised his wings and punched the side of the mountain. Boulders flew. Shishi roared, his claws scraping against the ground with a terrible screech. Shang managed to keep his balance. He held his spear above his head, and with one strong swoop, he threw it at Hugoi's head. The weapon lodged itself in the demon's left eye. With a thundering scream, Hugoi plucked the spear out of his eye and burned the weapon in his hands. The spear's ashes skated across the wind. Hugoi turned to Shang and Shishi and opened his mouth again, breathing out another terrible blaze. The flames snaked across the side of the volcano. They couldn't harm Shang, but Shishi let out a yelp when the fire singed his mane. Hugoi flew at them. Fiery rocks ripped from the sky, rocketing down to smash Shang and Shishi. He was playing with them, Mulan realized. Hugoi had countless opportunities to kill Shishi and her, but by separating them and toying with them, he was drawing out the inevitable. That was why he had dropped her off on the peak, on the wrong side of the peak, to torment her and remind her that time was running out. So against the bloodshot sky, the moon tantalized Mulan with its closeness. It was nearly cloaked in shadow. A sliver of its silvery light burnished with the demon's fire. She had to do something. Hugoi lifted his wing and struck at the captain, hurling him deeper into the underworld. Now Mulan wished Shang had learned to float and fly. As the ground shook, he tumbled down the mountain along with Shishi. If they fell into the river... Hey! Mulan shouted to the demon. It's me you want, not them. The fire demon's coal-black eyes turned to her. They glowed like embers, and the fire in his hand strengthened. Mulan ducked behind her shield, barely evading the column of flames Hugoi blasted her way. He didn't stop. Mulan held her shield tight to her chest, bending her head behind it. The smell of her hair burning and snuffled out the ends. Mulan counted the rhythm of the demon's attacks. When she gathered enough courage, she waited for the rest between blasts, then ran. Keep his attention away from Shang and Shishi, she thought frantically as she dashed across the summit. Give them time to climb back to safety. Hugoi's hands flared, hurling the streams of fire her way. The ground quaked again. Mulan couldn't afford to stumble. She widened her stride, pushed through the sharp twinge of pain in her ankle, and running until she reached the end of the cauldron's rim. When the blasts of fire stopped, the glow in Hugoi's black eyes disappeared. His eyes darkened, hollow and cold. He lowered his hand and insisted his body shook in laughter. The wind rippled and the sky thundered. Mulan backed up until she stood at the brink of the cauldron. One more step back and she'd tumble into the river. Not good. The river smothered the cauldron's mouth, a giant crater at the center of the peak, but smaller craters had formed along the rim. They bubbled and spurted now with bright hot lava. Mulan stumbled forward, her balance wobbling as the ground trembled. Demon soldiers surged up from the craters and rocks. They barged into the volcano surrounding Mulan and closing in on her. Unlike King Yama's or Miangpo's demons, the fire demon soldiers wore no armor. Their faces were scorched, red like Hugoi's, but their eyes were gray and vacant, their noses hollow, like skulls. Born from the cauldron to do Hugoi's bidding, they looked more like monsters than animals. Their chests bore scabs and burns like art or markings of identification. Some carried swords, others carried spears, and more than a few carried thick chain whips. The closest demon lashed his whip against the rock, unleashing a gust of searing debris that flew into Mulan's face. Ah! Mulan cried as the debris stung her cheeks. She blocked her face with her hand and glanced back at the edge of the cauldron. The river cut off her path down the mountain. Nowhere to run, but if she stayed here, could she fight the demons and win, while having time to reach the pillar? The demon sneered at her. Not even the ghosts come here, one growled. What brings you, mortal soldier? Are you in the mood to die? He looks afraid. Look at the quaking legs, a bit scrawny. Don't complain. It isn't often Hugoi gives us a feast. I'm going to slice his arms and drink his blood. I'm going to roast him on a spit. Give me his eyeballs. I love eyeballs. It's been so long since I had some. Too long, his comrade agreed. The last one carried a sword, too. More like a toothpick. I could use a new toothpick. Mulan thought fast. The only way off this volcano was to jump off, even if there wasn't streams of lava and jagged toothy precipices waiting her below. Leaving the cauldron wouldn't have been an option. She needed to get across the river. Not far away, she heard Shang's lion guardian scraping his way up from the opposite side of the mountain. She could barely see him. The river's murky water separated them like a wall. Smoke clung to his ruffled fur, and his sharp nails cut across the black mountain face. "Shishi!" Mulan cried. Shishi lifted his head when he heard her. His eyes widened when he saw the demons behind her. "Behind you!" the lion yelled. "Use your sword!" Wind muffled his next words. All she could hear was something about magic and demons. One of the demon's chains wrapped over Mulan's waist, half pulling her away from the edge. She rocked back on her heels, digging them into the dirt to slow herself from being dragged.